Here is the plans for the new crossbow I'm planning to build. It's called a medieval style crossbow, I think. The railing will be here. This is the trigger mechanism. The string will catch on to this part called the nut. And this is the trigger. It's called a tickler. When you pull the tickler, it allows the nut to spin and it releases the string. When the trigger is not pulled, it's blocking the nut and preventing it from rotating, and that is preventing the string from being released. But when you pull the trigger, it lets the nut free and releases the string. So these are the plans. I think I'll get started then. Okay. This is a small video showing you how I roll my paper. To roll your paper, you're gonna need a tapered part or a point to start from. You may recommend that we start from the corner over here, but I don't want to do that because if you start from a corner, the roll will be thicker in the middle and it will be slightly tapered at the edge. We want something that's perfectly straight. So what you do is you take your paper and you draw one line, fold it exactly in half. You draw a line at the center on one side and at the center on the other side. It should be, try to make it as exact as you can. Then you fold it in half and you cut a line such that when you unfold it, you get a kind of a tapered edge. And this makes it easier to start rolling it. The reason why I told you to draw the lines is when you start rolling, like I'm going to do now, try to get it as tight as you can. If it's not tight, open it and redo it again. But what you have to do is you have to roll it such that the line you've drawn at the center aligns with the line you have drawn at the back. Then you get your roll to be perfectly straight. Because we don't want to end up rolling like this and make it like a cone. So go all the way to the end and you will have a perfectly straight roll, which is also decently hard. Go to the end, tape it up, and when you're done, you should have something that looks like this. I have actually cut a part of mine because I want it to be the size of the railing, but you can keep your, but if you want it to be as long, you don't need to cut it. So I think you have the basic idea. Okay, I have finished most of the railing section except for the rails themselves. It took me about an hour or so, and I've cut them such that they match perfectly. So next time I will put the rail on and I'll start working on this outside stock, and then I will move on to the trigger mechanism. Then we should be nearly done.